Hi friends, this video is dedicated for fuzzy relations. Till now we have finished crisp sets, crisp fuzzy sets. Now crisp relations, we have discussed crisp relations also. Now we are going with fuzzy relations. Let us see what are these fuzzy relations and what are the difference between fuzzy relations and crisp relations and how we need to proceed with this. So, as we know, the topics to be discussed are crisp relations are already completed. Now we are moving to fuzzy relations. In this video, let us finish all fuzzy relations, fuzzy Cartesian product, cardinality of fuzzy relations, operations on fuzzy relations, properties of fuzzy relations, and composition. Let us finish all these things in this video. First, fuzzy relations. So fuzzy relations means it's a mapping of one universe to other universe through the Cartesian product of two universes. Let us see. That means here it's just like crisp relations only, but in crisp relation there is only two, one is zero and other one is one, but here it is the range. It's a, this is the value from zero to one, in between them also. So that's the thing. So the strength of the relationship between ordered pairs of two universes is not measured with the characteristic function. Here it's not measured with the characteristic function, that means either 1 or 0, it's not measured. So it's the degree of the strength is measured here, that means 0 or 1 or in between any of them. Okay, let us see if we take one example. Yes, this is the Cartesian product. Yeah, it's mu r of x comma y. So here the strength is mapped from x to y. Yes, coming to these fuzzy relations, cardinality and operations. So since as the cardinality of fuzzy sets is infinity, that means it's from 0 to 1. So they may be so infinite number of elements are existing from 0 to 1. So the cardinality of fuzzy sets is infinity. So obviously the relations also, the relations of two or more universes of fuzzy sets, so obviously it's a infinity. So coming to operations, so the first operation is, as we know, it's union. Mu r union s of x comma y is equal to maximum of mu r of x comma y mu s of x comma y. So it's very simple. If r and s are two fuzzy sets, so we can take the maximum value out of them so that we can get the value of our fuzzy membership value of r union s. Coming to intersection, so it is the minimum value out of r and s. So complement, so it is 1 minus mu r of x comma y. So containment is simple. So if r is contained by s, then mu r of x comma y is less than or equal to mu s of x comma y. That means s is the bigger picture and r is the smaller picture. So it shows that s is containing r. Simple. So next, the properties of fuzzy relations. So all the properties holds good here also, but these two are we already discussed in fuzzy sets also. R union R bar is not equal to the whole set, and R intersection R bar is not equal to the null set. Similarly, just like with fuzzy sets, so fuzzy Cartesian product and composition. Yeah, this is the thing. If A be a fuzzy set on universe X and B be a fuzzy set on universe Y, then the Cartesian product will be R, and that will be explained like this. A cross B is equal to R, it's a Cartesian product, and which is a subset of capital X cross capital Y. Okay, that we need to know, where the relationship is defined like this. Mu R is equal to mu a cross p of x comma y, and minimum of mu a of x comma y and mu b of x comma y. For example, if this is A, if A is having four elements, so the column vector is the mean, the vector's dimension or matrix dimension is 4 by 1. Suppose, and if B element have five elements, so it's a row matrix or row vector, so its size is 1 by 5. Just like matrix multiplication, and 1 and 1 will go off, and finally it remains with 4 by 5. So obviously I can say that the R is 4 by 5. Okay, this thing we need to keep in mind, and let us discuss while we are discussing the problems. Here all problems will be discussed in the next video. So this is the thing regarding fuzzy relations. Yeah, if you like this video, please like it. If you want to share this video, please share with your friends and family. And please do subscribe if you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, and try to press the bell button so that you will get the notifications whenever I upload any video. Thank you all. Yeah, I am extremely sorry, I have done a small mistake. I haven't added the composition, fuzzy composition in last time. Now I have added that part also. Let us see the fuzzy composition. Yeah, this is the fuzzy composition. As we know, just like crisp composition, here also there are two methods. One is max mean composition, second one is max product composition. So obviously the things are same. So instead of x, we need to find mu. Mu is the membership value. So obviously we know that this is maximum of minimum of mu or x comma y, and mu s of y comma z. That means we need to find the minimum value out of the relation R and the relation S, and then once we found the minimum value out of these two, then we need to find the maximum value. Then that value will be the value for T, the composition. Coming to max product composition, first we need to find the product of these two, and then we need to find the maximum. For crisp value, these two are the same, but coming to this fuzzy thing, these two values are not at all same, and we need to find the two things, and these two are not at all same. That means the composition T by using max mean method and the composition T by using max product method are different. Let us see why these are different and how they are different by taking an example. Okay, let us, this that video is the next video. Yeah, please like this video, share it, and if you haven't subscribed, please do subscribe. And if you have any doubts, please type in the comment box so that we can proceed with the solution of it. And please press the bell button so that you will get the notifications. Thank you. Thank you, one another.